Okay, hello there again. So it's 2:05 p.m. Pacific time, and it's on this day is Monday, April 1st. I'm gonna do some more videos here, at least one more for right now. Earlier in the day, I did a video and started in the chapter Gospel of Mark 1, so I'm going to pick it up from where I left off around the area. And what happens with me, I've been finding that as I read the word, and this is not necessarily the way it's always going to be, but this way it's been working, is that I'll read some word and then God will inspire me to talk about it and or pray. Okay, so I'm a prayer warrior. That's one thing that God has me do. And so anyway, I don't know what else God is going to have me do in life, but I do know that I'm a prayer warrior, so putting these videos on hopefully might inspire people to pray and know how to pray, and you don't have to think that I'm the only one, that knows how to pray and that can share how to pray. But I like to be a hands-on type of person, and I like doing these videos, and God has led me to do these videos. So let's get into the word here. Mark 1, chapter 1, verse 26. And when the unclean spirit had torn him and cried with a loud voice, he came out of him. And they were all amazed, insomuch that they questioned among themselves, saying, "What thing is this? What new doctrine is this? For with authority commandeth he even the unclean spirits, and they do obey him." You see, if you read the Word of God, and I suggest that you read it out loud, because faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. So you're speaking it, and you're reading it, and you're also hearing it as you read out loud, if you can read out loud. If you can't, that's fine. But that's what I believe is best, if you can. And so sometimes it's really good to just read and read and read and read. And then sometimes you will feel a presence of the Lord, a greater presence of the Lord. Most of the time you will. So just keep reading until you feel that, and you feel like there's something has been broken in the spirit where you're where things are lighter now. Things, I think, were broken in the spirit between last night, yesterday, and today. I don't know what happened. I just know something happened, and it was good, and something got broke in the spirit realm. Something bad got broken in the spirit realm. And I can't identify what happened and what it was. And I don't talk about this too much, because I try to just stay focused and not talk about things that aren't real. You know what I mean? So this is real. I don't know what happened, but something did break in the spirit for me, and possibly others. I don't know if you can feel that, but so just keep on keeping on. And they were all amazed. And this is verse 27. They were all amazed, in so much that they questioned among themselves, saying, "What thing is this? What new doctrine is this? For with authority commandeth he even the unclean spirits, and they do obey him." And immediately his fame spread abroad throughout all the region round about Galilee. See, something, he did something great over there. He cast that unclean spirit out. And then they said, and they were all amazed, insomuch that they questioned among themselves, saying, "What thing is this? What new doctrine is this? For with authority command." See, the Bible says the anointing destroys the yoke. He also says, "Not by might, not by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord." So, it all just is just really amazing. And I know that I'm talking to people that are believers, and that people that are not believers, people that are curious about God and the Bible and being saved. So I'm getting used to doing that. So sometimes I just like, spit it out, want to spit it out. But just thank you for your grace. I'm not, I haven't arrived. I haven't arrived. And forthwith, when they were come out of the synagogue, they entered into the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. But Simon's wife's mother lay sick of a fever, and anon they tell him of her. Anon, A-N-O-N, like anonymous. I just saw that in the Bible. But Simon's wife's mother lay sick of a fever, and anon they tell him of her. And he came and took her by the hand. Jesus came and took her by the hand and lifted her up. And immediately the fever left her, and she ministered unto them. He just came over. The power of Almighty God was living through Jesus. The power of Almighty God was living through, it still lives through him, in and through us, okay? And he took her by the hand and he lifted her up, and immediately the fever left her and she ministered unto them. When God does something good, then we have a tendency to want to minister to others, to be a servant of the Lord. And at even, when the sun did set, they brought unto him all that were diseased and them that were possessed with devils. So the sick and the demon-possessed, and all the city was gathered together at the door, and he healed many that were sick of divers diseases, and cast out many devils, and suffered not the devils to speak, because they knew him. And in the morning, rising up a great while before day, he went out and departed into a solitary place, and there prayed, and Simon and they that were with him followed after him. And when they had found him, they said unto him, All men seek for thee. And he said unto them, Let us go into the next towns, that I may preach there also, for therefore came I forth. And he preached in their synagogues throughout all Galilee, and cast out devils. And there came a leper to him, beseeching him, and kneeling down to him, and saying unto him, If thou wilt, thou canst cast me, make me clean. And Jesus, moved with compassion, put forth his hand, and touched him, and saith unto him, I will, be thou clean. And as soon as he spoke, as he had spoken, immediately the leprosy departed from him, and he was cleansed. And he straitly charged him, and forthwith sent him away, and saith unto him, See thou say nothing to any man, but go thy way, show thyself to the priest, and offer for thy cleansing those things which Moses commanded for a testimony unto them. But he went out and began to publish it much. He did just the opposite. I don't know if Jesus does that on purpose. He says, don't. It's like he did the opposite, and began to publish it much, and to blaze abroad the matter, insomuch that Jesus could no more openly enter into the city, but was without in desert place, and they came to him from every quarter. And I'm going to stop right there. Lord, we just thank you for your word. Thank you for faith, Lord, and that we can pray, God, for people to be delivered. And we do that right now in the name of Jesus, Lord. We pray and intercede for whosoever out there, God. They might not even be watching this video. We have to have enough faith, people, to pray beyond our own selves and our own selfishness and our own little territory. You know what I mean? That's what an intercessor does, okay? So I'll stop right there. Have a really good day, and God bless you. Bye-bye.